Everyone, today my data set is about the average IQ in various countries. So this is the basic data set I have chosen. It has 193 rows and 10 columns. The DL.column shows the number of columns which is there. Basically what I've done in this data set is the main topic is average IQ. So with each column like continent, literacy rate, motor prices, I've compared average IQ of the particular continent and the country to each problem like mean years of schooling, HDI and GNI. This is just an overview of what my presentation is going to be. As you can see, some of these bar graphs like population and countries are a bit blurred because there is a lot of data and it's difficult to compute that much data at one time. So what I've done first is I calculated the average literacy rate by continent. And as you can see, in Europe, in Asia has the highest literacy rate. Then I have compared the continent, I have taken the continent, I have summarized all the countries into continents, and then I have taken the continent versus average IQ of each continent. And then again continent I have taken with, I have chosen highest literacy rate. And I have even compared them with the number of Nobel Prizes. Then I chose the top 20 countries which have the highest average IQ. And this is the bar graph of that. Leading over there is Japan, which has the highest literacy rate and IQ. Now the factors which depend on the literacy rate are mean years of schooling, GNI, which is gross net income, also HDI. And this is a graph of that. Of the top 20 countries I had chosen before, this is a combination of the HDI and literacy rate of those top 20 countries. Now, is the average IQ related to number of the Nobel Prizes won in the particular country or the continent? This is the graph regarding that. These are the average IQs of the top 20 countries. This is a scatter plot of the average IQ per country versus their literacy rate. Based on the highest number of Nobel Prizes, I have accumulated the data and compared them with the top 20 countries with the highest Nobel Prizes. Although the literacy rate of Japan is the highest, the number of Nobel Prizes are highest in US. This is the distribution of IQ across different continents. Does HDI, like Human Development Index, does that matter when it comes to education? Yes, that's what it shows, that countries like Hong Kong, Singapore, Japan are highest, while some countries like Liberia or some countries in Africa are lower on this chart, which shows that HDI plays a very important role. This is a graph of the Nobel Prizes country-wise. This is the frequency of the literacy rate per continent. Again, does the number of years you've gone to school depend on your average IQ? Again, as we can see, again Japan is leading in this as well, while the lowest is Nepal. This is a graph of the GNI and how it matters for each thing. So I have done a graph of GNI and GNI versus average IQ. How does that matter for each country and how it is determined? Again, I have taken HDI. HDI is Human Development Index. That is how much a country has the money to provide education. This is again a scatter plot of mean years of schooling versus average IQ. Finally, this is a pair plot which shows all the columns I've just mentioned, that is HDI, Nobel Prize winners, literacy rate and average IQ. This is a heat map. A heat map is usually used when you have a lot of data to compare, both on the X and Y axis, and this gives you a clearer picture of the data. These are all the data in one graph. Finally, this is a correlation matrix which I have done, which shows It's basically the consolidation of my whole analysis which I've done. So from this analysis I found out that Japan has the highest literacy rate while Nepal has the lowest literacy rate based on average IQ. And the highest literacy rate is in Asia and Europe out of everything else. And the GNI and HDI of each country or continent also adds value to the average IQ or the average literacy rate of the particular continent.